So, you want to play your favorite mobile games in 60 FPS? Let me show you how. First, let's go over the prerequisites. 1. A highly refreshed screen. If you have 90Hz screen, you are going to get 45 FPS. And if you have 120Hz, you get 60 FPS. Whatever refresh rate you may have, you are going to get half of it. 2. Your game must be made in Unity. Unity is a game engine, and if you don't know what engine your game is using, just try it anyway. Most mobile games are made in Unity. Now, there are two ways we can trick our game to run at 60 FPS. The first way is universal and work on all phones. The second way may be exclusive to gaming phone that can lock FPS for a specific game. So, let's begin with the universal method. All you have to do is change your screen refresh rate to be the highest your phone support. Then, enter the game and the FPS should be half of your refresh rate. This works with Shadowverse. As you can see, scrolling through the card is much more smoother. Now, if that method didn't work, then let's move on to the gaming phone method. For this method, you need to set your system refresh rate to 60Hz. And then, set the game refresh rate to 120Hz. Start up the game, and the game shouldn't be running at 60 FPS yet. Simply go back to home screen, and then back to the game, and voila! The game is now in 60 FPS. For some reasons, if you use screenshot button, the game go back to 30 FPS. Just go back to home screen, and then back in the game again, and the game should be back to 60 FPS. You may wonder why this is working. I'm not a game developer, but I believe the game is using half VSync, which is why it's making you run the game at half refresh rate of what your screen has, potentially to save battery and reduce frame drop. But since we made it run at higher frame rate, your phone is going to be hotter and burn more battery than usual, so beware of that. Now, if this video is useful, then why not hit that like button? Leave a comment whether it works or not for your phone. And if you want to see more from me, then why not also press that subscribe button? And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye. Maybe this could be just Asus ROG Phone 2 bug.